minus 1 is less than k. Fine, n minus 1, n minus 9 is less than k, or k is greater than n minus 1. Now I have got two inequations in this and this, which represents k. So there should be a common solution for k. This inequation says that k is greater than minus 7, and this equation says k is greater than n minus 9. So k has to be greater than minus 7 also, k has to be greater than n minus 9 also. So what is the solution for k? Naturally, maximum of n minus 9 and 7, whichever be the maximum, k has to be greater than or equal to this. Likewise, let us take this, k has to be less than or equal to 6, and k has to be less than n minus 9, n minus 3. That means k can assume at most a value 6, k can assume at most a value n minus 3. That means k has to be less than minimum of 6 n minus 3. 6 n minus 3. So limit on k becomes the summation limits. This is of course 1 into 1. K has to be greater than maximum of n minus 9 minus 7, and this is minimum of 6 n minus 3. Let us take a number line, discrete number line, 0, 1, 2, so on so forth. Now n is a varying number, n can vary in this range. So as n varies, n minus 9 varies. So out of this, either this will be maximum or this will be maximum when n varies like this, but both will be equal when n minus 9 becomes minus 7. They will equal when n minus 9 becomes minus 7, that means n equal to 2. So n equal to 2, at n equal to 2, both these elements becomes equal. Now take a value of n which is less than 2, say minus 1. If n is minus 1, this becomes what? Minus 10, and this is minus 7, so this is maximum. Take a value of n 0, 0 minus 9 is minus 9, so this is maximum. Take 1, this is minus 8, this is maximum. So that means if n varies from minus infinity to 2, this remains maximum. Okay? And after 2, say take a value 3, if you take 3, 3 minus 9 minus 6, this becomes maximum. So we can say that this is a boundary, n equal to 2 is a boundary which previous to this one element is maximum, and after this another element is maximum. Let us see what happens here. Same argument, n varies between minus infinity to infinity. So when as n varies, this also vary. So thereby the which element is minimum and which one is not, they also vary. But when n minus 3 becomes 6, then both of them becomes equal. So let us find n minus 3 equal to 6, so n becomes 9. So n becomes, when n becomes 9, then these two elements vary. So this is one step. In step 1, we have to find for what value of n these two elements are equal, And for what value of n these two elements will evolve? Possibly you will find two boundaries. Next point is how to determine the range of n. Look here, since n is varying, this is a set, fine, this is the variable element of the set, like that this is also variable element of the set. So, this form a set. One thing which is required from this constant, that every element of this set has to be greater than equal to the every element of this. Look here carefully, every element of this set has to be greater than equal to every element of this. This requires 6 has to be greater than n, greater than or equal to n minus 9. 6 greater than equal to n minus 9, that means n is less than equal to 15, that means n can become at most 15. Let us draw 15 here. The value of n can be at most 15. Likewise, now 6 has to be greater than equal to minus 7, which is universal truth. Let us take this element, n minus 3 has to be greater than n minus 9, which is also universal truth, because this is true, n minus 3 is greater than equal to n minus 9, greater than minus for any value of n. You can take any value of, because the n cancels, minus 3 is always greater than minus 9. So, this is universal truth. Next, n minus 3, this n minus 3 has to be greater than or equal to minus 7. So, n has to be greater than or equal to minus 7 plus 3, that means n has to be greater than or equal to minus 4. So, there is some number minus 4, n has to be greater than this. That means the non-zero product of xn and hn minus k, non-zero product of xn and xk and hn minus k will lie, will be only in this range, non-zero product of xk and hn minus k will be in the range which extend from minus 4 to 15. Outside this range, this product will be 0, that means yn will be 0. Prior to this range, this product will again be 0, that means yn is 0. This we can check from here itself. We found the upper limit of n was n less than equal to 15, n has to be greater than equal to minus 4, it was, yeah, minus 4. Let us take a value of n which is less than minus 4, say minus 6. Say we select a value of n which is minus 6, less than minus 4, you can have any value. If I take n as minus 6, this set becomes 6 minus 9, this should be greater than equal to, let us take n equal to minus 6, minus 6 means minus 15 and minus 7. This every element of this has to be greater than equal to this. Whether minus 9 is greater than equal to minus 9? No. So, that means if we violate, if we change a value of n beyond this range, then these two form this joint set and this product will be 0. So, this guarantees that yn, the convolved result of this for a value less than minus 4 is 0, yn will be 0, again it will be 0 when n is less than minus 4 and when n is greater than 15, these two. Then let us see what happens in this range. Let us have that number line again. N was 15, N was minus 4. The first boundary was this, N minus 9 equal to minus 7. That means N equal to 2. And this was N minus 3 is equal to 6. That means N equal to 9. Okay. Then this is the number line on N. This represents a discrete number line N. Now, as N varies, in range minus 4, I am excluding this 2, I will include this in another range. As N varies in this range, let us see which one is maximum and which one is minimum here. N is minus 4, this becomes minus 13, so this is maximum. As we move here, minus 4 to 1, say take minus 2, then n equal to minus 2, then we see minus 11, this again remains 1. Take n equal to 1, then this becomes minus 8, this remains maximum. So, in this range, k equal to minus 7 is the maximum. Again, let us see what is this. When n is minus 4, this is minus 7. When n is say minus 1, then this is minus 4, this is minimum, and when n is 1, this is minus 2, this is minimum. So, the upper limit becomes minus 3 and we have to sum 1. This will be yn in this range. Now, we have to solve this. My experience with the students are there. They are comfortable with solving a series when the series starts with a 0 index, otherwise they are not comfortable. So, if we want to do that, create a 0 here. This we can do by putting k plus 7 as some other variable k prime, k plus 7 as k prime. When k is minus 7, k prime becomes, when k is minus 7, minus 7 plus 7 0. So, k prime becomes 0. When k is minus 7, k prime becomes 0. And when k is n minus 3, when k is n minus 3, then we get n minus 3 plus 7 as k prime. That means n plus 4 is k prime. Then this summation now becomes yn summation over k dash 0 to n plus 4 summation 1. Index is start from 0, 0 to n plus 4. 0 to n plus 4 will be how many terms will be included? N plus 5. So, 1 is being summed up n plus 5 number of times. So, this becomes n plus 5. Yn. Now, let us write the kya board banaya. Then yn, the real for yn is, this is 0 when n is greater than minus 4. Now, this is n plus 5 in the range minus 4. Let us see the other range. Now, when n varies, this is range 1 up to 1. Now, up to 1, the another number is 2. Let us take the another range up to 8. That means, as n varies from 2 to 8, then what happens? n varies in the range this, let us see which one is maximum and which one is minimum. When n becomes 2, this becomes minus 7, both are equal, and when n becomes 3, this becomes minus 6, this becomes minus 7, this becomes maximum. When n becomes 8, 8 minus 1, then this becomes minus 1 and this becomes 7, so this becomes maximum. In that case, k starts from maximum value k n minus 9. Now here, when n becomes 2, 2 minus 3 is minus 1, and when n becomes 8, 8 minus 3 is 5, so this remains minimum, n minus 3 remains minimum, and we have to sum k. Again you can create a 0 here, same method, you create a 0 here and then this sum will become seven. You will get his sum as 7, yn becomes 7. So yn is now 7 in the range 2 less than n less than 8. Now 8 to 15, as n varies from 8 to 15. Just again check what is the maximum and what is the minimum. N equal to 8, this is minus 1. When n equal to, take a value in between, say 12. When n minus 12 minus 9, 3, this remains maximum. 15 minus 9, this remains maximum. So this is maximum, all right. What happens here? When n is 8, 8 minus 3, 8 minus 3 is 5, 5 is less than 6, so this becomes minimum. Let us take a 9, 9 minus 3, 9 minus 3 is what? 6. It equals, and then we have made a mistake, fine, 38, so range should be 9. From 9 to this, 9 minus 3 is 6, both are equal, 10, 10 minus 3, this is 7, so this is minimum, 12, 12 minus 3, this is 9, so this remains minimum, minimum changes. Now you can again create a 0 by the procedure I have told you, and you can find the sum is, in that case the sum will be 16 minus 1, check it, because I am doing oral. Yeah, so this will be 16 minus n in the range and 0, I am writing here so that you are able to 0 when n greater than 15. Exact similar treatment you can do in solving any problem in continuous time domain. Continuous time domain. Let me take a problem